stand and sing hymn of praise, Praise to the Lord Almighty, number 139 in your hymnal. Affirmation of faith printed in your bulletin. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
To the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Our Old Testament reading this morning comes from the book of Isaiah 58. Shout it aloud, do not hold back. Raise your voice like a trumpet. Declare to my people their rebellion and to the house of Jacob their sins. For the day after day they seek me out. They seem eager to know my ways, as if we were a nation that does what is right and has not forsaken the commands of its God. They ask me for just decisions and seem eager for God to come near them. Why have we fasted, they said, and you have not seen it? Why have we humbled ourselves and you have not noticed? Yet, on the day of your fasting, you do as you please and exploit all your workers. Your fasting ends in quarreling and strife and striking each other with wicked fits. You cannot fast as you do today and expect your voice to be heard on high. It is the kind of fast that I have chosen, only a day for a man to humble himself. It is only for bowing one's head like a reed and for lying on the sackcloth and ashes. It is what you call a fast, a day acceptable to the Lord. It is not the kind of fasting I have chosen, to loose the chains of injustice and untie the cords of the yoke, to set the oppressed free and to break every yoke. It is not to share your food with the hungry and provide the poor wanderer with shelter. When you see the naked, clothe them, and do not turn away from your own flesh and blood. Then your light will break, for like the dawn, and your healing will quickly appear. Then your righteousness will go before you, and the glory of the Lord will be your rear guard. Then you will call, and the Lord will answer. You will cry for help, and he will say, here I am. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Oh, that's me, sorry. I'd like to call the children up for children's time. How are you guys this morning?
Good.
Mm-hmm. Good. I brought us a little thing. You're good. Can you read?
Yeah.
Can you read what that says?
Live with purpose.
Live with purpose. Okay, so I brought this to keep us on track today. Did you guys know there was a time when there was no such thing as a refrigerator? And I wonder what they did with no place to put their milk. Or how about meat? What happens if you don't put meat in the refrigerator?
It goes bad.
It goes bad, right. So you know what they did to keep their meat from going bad when they didn't have a refrigerator? They put salt on it. You know why? Because the salt kept the meat fresh, right? And so Pastor Linda is going to tell us a little bit later about how we are the salt of the earth. You know what that means? That means that we are supposed to keep the earth fresh. Just like the salt keeps meat fresh, we keep the earth fresh. Does that sound pretty cool? So live with a purpose, meaning we all have a specific purpose, even though it might be a little different from each other, that God has put us on this earth to do, right? Okay, you want to pray? Anybody want to pray? Okay. Dear Jesus.
Dear Jesus,
thank you for this day.
Thank you for this day.
And thank you for making us special.
And thank you for making us special.
We love you.
We love you.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. And it's family worship, so we're going to sit back down.
As we go to God in prayer this morning, there are are many in the bulletin that are listed that request your prayers. We also are glad to report to you that Michaela Hunter, one of our youth that has been in the hospital for some time, is now at home. She was able to go home Thursday night, and she'll be on half days at school for a while, but we give God great praise for her progress. For Madison Tolbert as well, Madison is at home following her accident, and we give God great praise for that as well. There are many others in our congregation and our community that need our prayers, and we offer our prayers and our hearts to them. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, through the testimony of those who know your love, you have guided us to ask for what we need. So we come before you this morning with our hearts open to you, approaching your throne with confidence, knowing that you hear our every word. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, you called us to be your disciples, to live as a city on a hill and a lamp on a stand, so that everyone can see the glory of God and know your love. We pray for the church, the community of disciples. We pray for us that we will be able to claim your name and be the salt of the earth and to shine the light into the dark world. Lord, in your mercy. Holy God, you gave the law to show us the way of righteousness. Help us to receive your commandments as grace and to live as your obedient children, that your goodness may shine through us, that others may see your love and your grace. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, open our understanding by the power of the Holy Spirit, that as we gather as your people today, that we will hear your word, that we will receive holy wisdom to understand the gifts that you have bestowed on us and the call that you have on our lives. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, we pray for our world, for the governments and for its leaders. May all who rule honor justice and compassion to all people and serve the common good so that the people may flourish. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, you teach us to offer food to the hungry and satisfy the needs of the afflicted. We pray for the sick, for the hungry, for the poor, the homeless, for those who are oppressed. Let us, your church, minister to those in distress and bear witness to your abiding compassion to all who suffer. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, we come before you this morning hungry for you. Help us, Lord, to be the salt so that we can change the world, so that we can transform the world into your love. Help us to be the light. Help us, Lord, to show others your love, so that those that are in despair may see your light. Lord, we ask that you shine light into our darkness as well. Help us to see your grace and help us to claim your love. For we pray through Christ, with Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit forever and ever. Amen. like a spring whose waters never fail, God calls us to share what we have received. Let us offer ourselves and our gifts to God. Let us worship God with God's tithes and our offerings.
Thank you. is tried to light his own candle some other way. See now your sister, she's been robbed and lied to, still holds a candle without a flame. Carry your candle, run to the darkness, seek out the hopeless, confused and torn. Hold out your candle for all to see. Hearts are blazing. Let's raise our candles, light up the sky. Pray to our Father in the name of Jesus. Make us a beacon in darkest times. Carry your candle, run to the dark.
Our gospel today comes from the Gospel of Matthew. Please stand as you are able for the reading of the gospel. This is the gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ according to St. Matthew, Matthew chapter 5, verses 13 through 20. Jesus said, "You are the salt of the earth, but if salt has lost its taste, how can its saltiness be restored? It is no longer good for anything, but is thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city built on a hill cannot be hid. No one, after lighting a lamp, puts it under the bushel basket, but on the lampstand, and it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven. Do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have come not to abolish, but to fulfill. For truly I tell you, until heaven and earth pass away, not one letter, not one stroke of a letter will pass from the law until all is accomplished. Therefore, whoever breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches others to do the same will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever does them and teaches them will be called great in the kingdom of heaven. For I tell you, unless your righteousness exceeds that of the scribes and Pharisees, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven." This is the word of God for us, the people of God. You may be seated. If you go buy salt today, you are confronted with a lot of different choices. There is the regular old table salt that has a little bit of iodine in it. The iodine is to keep it from clumping together. I was also told earlier today that iodine in salt was put there to prevent goiters in the South. I did not know that. See what you learn when you come to church? There's also sea salt that is made from the evaporating seawater. When I was in Israel, Palestine, our group of 25 clergy put on our bathing suits and we took a dip in the Dead Sea, basically swimming in salt. Actually, we did very little swimming. It was more like floating. It's quite an experience. There's also Himalayan pink salt that you cook with. There's kosher salt. There's Celtic salt. Salt is a combination of two elements. Okay, you chemistry majors, what are those two elements? Sodium chloride. Wow, we got a lot of chemistry people here today. Salt is absolutely essential in life for humans and for animals. It does important stuff like regulating our brain and regulating our electrical impulses. Salt is used on food to enhance flavor or alter the taste of food. It makes food come alive. It brings taste alive. Salt is also, as you just heard Amy say, it can be used as a preservative. Bacteria have a hard time growing in salt. In Judaism, salt was a symbol of the covenant between God and God's people. Salt was a sign of commitment in that covenant community. Some of us like a lot of salt, and some of us like a little of salt. Jesus says, we are the salt of the earth. Pass the salt, please. The purpose of light is to illumine. Physics majors, what is the property of light that allows light to do its job of illumination? Anybody know? Okay, I'll tell you. Visible light is emitted and absorbed in these tiny packets called, remember, photons, and exhibits properties of both waves and particles. This property is referred to as wave-particle duality. Another great thing you're learning in church today. The other principle of light, of course, is what? Refraction, right? The change in the direction of the wave propagation due to a change in the transmission medium makes it refract. Now you've learned a little bit of chemistry and a little bit of physics in church today. Aren't you glad you came? Our main source of natural light is, of course, sunlight. And we also get light from fire. Without sunlight, though, there would be no photosynthesis, meaning no green plants, meaning no carbon dioxide, or food, or other energy that we need to survive. Light is essential for life. Without light, we can become dreary and depressed. Sunlight lifts our spirits and makes us feel better. It has been shown that those that live in climates of rain and a dreary climate are more depressed than those that live in sunny and warm climates. Without light, we would sit in the darkness and not be able to see the stars or to see anything else. Light stimulates our sight and makes things visible. Light shows us where to walk, who we are talking to, where we are going. Light shows us the way, the truth, and gives us life. Jesus says, we are the light of the world. Turn on the light, please. Turn on the light and pass the salt. As soon as Jesus tells us that we are the salt of the earth and the light of the world, he goes into this explanation of the law and the prophets. What does light and salt have to do with law and prophets? Well, here's what it has to do. This is why you came to church today. This is what it has to do with one another. Light and salt and law and prophets, it has to do with righteousness. Not righteousness like the Pharisees and the scribes, says Jesus. Not righteousness like the Pharisees and the scribes that say that they are good, who obey every single ordinance of the law, who follow all the rules, standing around and praying out loud so all can see them. Not like the righteousness of the Pharisees and the scribes who judge others without taking a good look inside. Not that kind of righteousness. Jesus says he does not come to abolish the law, but to fulfill it. It's a new kind of righteousness. And this righteousness has to do with salt and with light. The righteousness has to do with love. Jesus extends the mission of God without dismissing the tradition of the old covenant. And he points to the commandments, not dismissing the commandments, but when he is asked later in his ministry about which is the greatest commandment, he answers with the Shema from the old covenant, to love God with your whole heart, your whole soul, and your whole mind. And then he adds, to love your neighbor as yourself. He includes the Old Testament commandment and then fulfills it with loving our neighbor. Friends, this is the core of our Christian faith. Righteousness is to love. In this radical explanation of Jesus in the Sermon on the Mount, Jesus is calling us to be righteous by being the salt in the earth that changes the world, that alters the world. So as Christians, we stand for justice, and we bring out the goodness in the world. We free the oppressed, we feed the hungry, we give water to the thirsty, we clothe the naked, we visit the sick and those imprisoned, we welcome the stranger and the refugee. Being salt means that we do things differently, and we bring out the good flavor of the world, working for goodness, working against evil. Being salt means that we change the world for good, for the goodness of God. Jesus says we are to be the salt, intensifying the flavor of the world around us, loving our neighbor as ourselves. In this radical explanation of Jesus in the Sermon on the Mount, Jesus is calling us to be righteous by being the light that illumines the world. We bring hope to those who are in darkness. We work to bring life to all people, not just the necessities of life, which are important, but an abundant life. Jesus came to give us an abundant life. So being the light of the world means that we work so that others can have hope and can be delivered from their despair, from the darkness that they live in. Whatever that despair might be, being the light of the world means that Christ gives us light in our darkness. Being light means that we sparkle, that we gleam, that we shimmer, that we shine. Jesus says we are the light, shining God's grace into the despair and the fear that many people feel. Our goodness is to be so obvious. Our righteousness of love is to be so obvious, so in evidence that through our presence, the very presence of God's love and grace is felt in those around us. That being salt and being light is so evident that others can see the love of Christ shining through us, hearing from us. And in this discourse, Jesus says that we are to do that as a community, together, that we do life together. today in our current social and political environment, I think this is more important than ever before, that we come together and focus on Jesus, as Pastor Lori said so elegantly the other week. That we come together and we focus on Jesus, that we do as Jesus calls us to do, that we are Christian first and foremost, that we are the salt of the earth and the light of the world, that the gospel of Christ is the first in our lives, not other stuff, but the gospel. That we turn on the light and we pass the salt. We turn on the light and we give hope to others. We pass the salt and we alter the world. So as you come to this table today, as you come to the table today, may your life be altered. May you receive the salt that Christ gives us to be and calls us to be. And may you receive hope. May you know that grace which transforms and sustains us so that we may be salt and be the light that transforms and sustains others. May you come to this table today and experience God's grace and God's love in such a powerful way that you can be the salt and the light of the world. As you come today, may you know that God welcomes you here, transforms you, gives you grace, loves you, so that you can be transformed, so that you can go out and love others and shine light into their despair. As you come today, may you be filled with His love and His power. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now, if you will take your hymnal and turn to page 12 and stand as you are able. Please join me in the invitation, the confession, and pardon. Christ our Lord invites to His table all who love Him, who earnestly repent of their sin and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sin before God and one another. Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved You with our whole heart. We have failed to be an obedient church. We have not done Your will. We have broken Your law. We have rebelled against Your love. We have not loved our neighbors, and we have not heard the cry of the needy. Forgive us, we pray. Free us for joyful obedience through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now let us confess in silence. Amen. Hear the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. That proves God's love toward us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
Glory to God. Amen. You may be seated. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Almighty God, Creator of heaven and earth. You formed us in your image and breathed into us the breath of life. When we turned away and our love failed, your love remained steadfast. You delivered us from captivity, made covenant to be our sovereign God, and spoke to us through the prophets. And so, with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. Your Spirit anointed him to preach good news to the poor, to proclaim release to the captives and recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty those who are oppressed, and to announce that the time had come when you would save your people. He healed the sick, he fed the hungry, and he ate with sinners. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. When the Lord Jesus ascended, he promised to be with us always in the power of your word and Holy Spirit. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, broke the bread, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice, in union with Christ offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ is died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here, and all these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory, and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, with the confidence of the children of God, let us pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. I invite our communion stewards to come forward. Because there is one loaf, we who are many are one body, for we all partake of the one loaf. The bread which we break is a sharing in the body of Christ. The cup over which we give thanks is a sharing in the blood of Christ. Paul, this is the body of Christ broken for you. Amen. This is his body broken for you. Blend of the body of Christ broken for you. This is his blood. For you. His blood shed for you, Amy. And this is his blood shed for you. The table is ready. Come and receive. There will be a gluten-free station over here on the side that Linda will be glad to serve you. As you come today, open your hearts. This is not a Methodist table. This is the Lord's table. Come today, open your hearts and receive. I'm going to do something a little bit different today. We are having kneeling communion today. If you cannot kneel, just come forward and stand, and we will serve you at your place. If you cannot come forward, stay where you are, and the ushers will tell us, and we will serve you at the end. But as you come today to be fed, I'm going to ask that you, as you heard Janet talk earlier about our mission project to feed the hungry in the world, I'm going to ask that you come and bring an offering and you lay it on this altar, just a dollar or $20 or $100, whatever you feel. Just bring it and lay it on the altar today as an offering. As we are being fed, then we will reach out and feed others the love of Christ. Come today and be altered. Come today and know that God loves you and asks you to come to be transformed so that you can be the salt and the light of the world. Jesus said, "You are the light of the world." Go in peace. Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. Go in peace." Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. And he takes care of the sheep. Go in peace. Grace is more than sufficient. Go. Jesus came so that we could have life and have it abundantly. Go in peace. in Christ, they are a new creation. Go in peace. Let us pray. Eternal God, we give you thanks for this holy mystery in which you have given yourself to us. Grant that we may go into the world in the strength of your Spirit to give ourselves for others so that we can be the salt and the light of the world. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, we pray. Amen. Now, if you'll stand as we sing our closing hymn, let us break bread together.
Together on our knees, let us.
said, "Let your light shine before others so that they may see your good works and know Christ's love and give glory to your Father in heaven. May Christ, the true light, shine upon each of you, that you may walk in love and righteousness all of your days. In Jesus' name, amen."
May the God of hope go with us every day, filling all our lives with love and joy and peace. May the God of justice lead us on our way.